So you would be in a disturbed camp.
I'm disturbed by it. For so many reasons. I think if you're old enough to ask for it, you probably shouldn't have it. You're too old. A lot of doctors have said that it's actually okay, but emotionally,
why is it not okay when you're old
enough
to ask for it? Because, and psychologists say, this is going to create serious dependency issues among probably other issues for this child, let's be honest. And I really do think that this child, it's a very dangerous thing to do this. It's very strange. He's going to have issues with this, plus the judgment from outside. But here's the thing. The woman isn't doing it just because she thinks this is a bonding moment. She says, I'm lazy.
She's too lazy.
I don't feel like getting out of bed.
Yeah. I know.
That's
you know, the larger problem.
Poor sort of lactivists, you know, we talked about this place. That's what they call it. We talked about this place, the Upper Breast Side in Manhattan, where literally, if you ask for the cover up to breastfeed your baby, they call it a hooter hider, and you have to pay a dollar for even asking for it. They say it's natural, and even by us having this discussion, we are making people feel uncomfortable about the breast, which is not a sexual organ, but meant to feed.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's an easy story. I agree with you. I cringed at the notion of, you know, it's cold out, it's economic, frankly, I'm lazy. By the way, she breastfeeds her infant son at the same time.
Yeah.
And she calls it difficult. It's difficult for a reason. If it's difficult, you know, take
the thing is, so you breastfeed your baby, but then you wean your baby. Same way you stop putting him in diapers. The same way you stop letting it behave like an infant. You have to, you know, instill independence in them. Before we go, Christina Applegate, speaking of, you know, pregnancy and baby. Christina Applegate is pregnant and expecting a baby, I think, in a couple of months. Mm-hmm. And she decided to do a little pole.
HBO is to take a celebrity name and then a controversial term like pole dancing and then hit it out of the park on the internet.
Job well done.
Totally. To say people are searching for this would be an understatement.
I'm sure the rest of America does, though. Most guys are going.
Something about the whole tights, the stockings.
Megyn is the only one with a bump sitting here today. Do you want to weigh in on this?
I have to say, I think sexiness is a state of mind. Yeah. And I honestly, like, I can tell you truly, I feel no differently now in terms of my sex appeal in my relationship than I did when I wasn't pregnant. It's like, it's what you got going on up here. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, so are we going to see you on the pole?
Yeah, no pole.
Prenatal pole dancing.
Honestly, I wouldn't know what to do if I got married.
I think the better trick would be postnatal pole dancing with the baby on an arm and the pole dancing.
You
probably
know,
harder.
Your husband is somewhere ordering you a pole to be.
Since I haven't been on the Stairmaster in months, I could probably use it. So in any event. All right, ladies. Always a pleasure. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Well, she went from beauty queen to queen of mean in just a few short years. A smart and sexy model. Beauty queen, truly. Convicted of kidnapping and torturing her ex-boyfriend. But did the crime, she did the crime, but did she maybe get lucky on the time? That's next in Kelly's Court.